Good morning, students. Here I am, Mrs. Tanya. And in the last class, I have explained you of Act 2, Scene 2 only, from line number 1 to 29. Okay? So here we will start from line number 30 to 68 of Act 2, Scene 2. In the beginning, you might have understood that in this scene, it is talking about Lancelot. I gave the introduction, who is Lancelot. Then old Gobbo, father of Lancelot. Okay? So we will continue with the scene of these two characters, Lancelot and old Gobbo. And the scene starts from line number 33, where old Gobbo enters with a basket. He had a basket, with that he enters. He says, as he come, as previous scene, previous extract, what happened? Lancelot was leaving the place of Shylock. Okay, so as Gobbo entered the street of Venice, he saw Lancelot. Because Lancelot was stepping out. So Gobbo was half blind. Okay, he couldn't see properly. Just he identified that one person is there in front of him. So he said, Master young man, you I pray you, which is the way to Master Jews? He said, young man, can you tell me which is the way to the house of old Jew, means Shylock, Lancelot. He was standing aside and he said, oh heavens, this is my true begotten father. He said, oh God, he is my father. Means after a long time he is meeting his father. He just left him here with Shylock and he went away. So Lancelot was really shocked. He said, oh, he is my begotten father, who being more than sand blind, and he is more than half blind. Means just not half blind, but more than half blind. High gravel blind means you can call him completely blind. Okay. Knows me not, I will try confusions with him. Now Lancelot, as you know, he was very humorous character here. So now he thought that he is completely blind. He will not be able to identify me properly. So now it is a good time to have some fun with my father. And let me confuse him. Let me let me have fun with him. So again Gobbo said, Master young gentleman, I pray you, which is the way to Master Jew? Again he repeated the same question. He said, young man, can you please tell me the way to old Jew's house? Then Lancelot says, turn up on your right hand at the next turning, but at the next turning of all on your left. Now here he started playing with his father. He said, see, go to your right at the next turn, but at the next bend, turn to your left. Go to your right at the next turn, but at the next turn, turn to your left. Marry. Now, marry means he's swearing God, swearing Mary, like taking swear means oath of Mary. He said, I swear by blessed Mary, I say, at the very next turning, turn off no hand. He said, at the very next turning, do not turn anywhere. Means first go right, then turn, but at the next turning, turn. Don't bend, turn to your left. I swear by Blessed Mary that next turning do not turn anywhere. Then take that turning and don't turn anywhere. But turn down indirectly to the Jew's house. But later turn down towards the Jew's house. But later turn around and turn down towards the Jew's house. Actually, where they were standing behind, it was Jew's house only. So directly he can send him to the Jew's house, but he wanted to crack joke, he wanted to amuse, and Shakespeare himself wanted to give some amusement to the people. So Lancelot just played a trick. He said, turn to your right, then next turn don't bend, turn to your left, then at left turn don't turn anywhere, turn down and there will be Jew's house. Means indirectly all over if he will turn, he will come to the same place. Means where he is standing, again he will come to the same place. Now Gobbo said, by God, Santis, 12 be a hard way to hit. Now old Gobbo said, by God, it is a hard way, it's very difficult path. Can you tell me whether one Lancelot that dwells with him, dwell with him or no? So he said, the way what you are telling, it's very difficult. But can you tell me one thing? With that old Jew, there was one person named Lancelot. He used to live with Shylock. That do he still live with him? Lancelot. Talk you of young Master Lancelot? Now again Lancelot started playing with his father. He said, are you talking about young Master Lancelot? aside, mark me now. Now will I raise the waters. Talk ye of young master Launcelot. Now again Launcelot said, now let me see, look at me now. Now I will bring tears into his eyes. And again he said, are you talking about young master Launcelot? Now he called himself as a master. Because old Gobo said, do you know Launcelot? He said, young master Launcelot, means he wanted to tell his father that not just a simple person, he's a master, he's a great person, lord. So he said, are you talking about young master Launcelot? So Gobo said, no master sir. He said, no, don't call him master, but he's a poor man's son. He said, he's a son of a poor man, he's not a master, he's not a lord. His father, though I say, it's an honest, exceeding poor man, and God be thanked, well to live. He said, if I say, although I say it myself, is an honest man, in spite of being very poor. His father, he's talking about himself, he's saying, he's a very poor man, but an honest man. And thank God, he leads a good life. But I thank God that he is leading a good life. Means, in fact, he was happy. His son is leading a good life, but he's saying, don't call him a master because he is son of a poor man. Launcelot says, well, let his father be what he will. We talk of young master Launcelot. Launcelot said, let him father be a poor man. It's not matter, but he is a young master. He is a master. Means he is a young master Launcelot. Whatever be his father, let it be. Old Gobo said, your worship friend and Launcelot sir. Now Gobo said, yes sir, your young friend Launcelot. Now he also agreed. He said, okay, young friend Launcelot sir. Launcelot again said, but I pray you ergo, old man ergo, beseech you, talk you of young master Launcelot. Launcelot said, but I ask you therefore, old gentleman, are you referring young master Launcelot? Are you really talking about young master Launcelot? Are you talking about him? Gobo, of Launcelot, and please your mastership. Gobo said, yes, to Launcelot if you please, sir. He said, yes, I am talking about him only. So Launcelot again started making fun. He again created another story. Now he said, master ergo means therefore. Therefore, Master Launcelot, talk not of Master Launcelot. He said, now if I say, do not speak about Master Launcelot. Father, for the young gentleman, he said, father, he said, he called him old gentleman. This young gentleman, according to fates and destinies, according to the fate and destiny, and such odd saying, the sisters three, and such branches of learning, is indeed diseased, or as you would say in plain terms, gone to heaven. Now here in this extract, Launcelot wants to tell old Gobo in a very hi-fi way. Like some people who knows English, they instead of telling a very simple expression in a very simple words, easy words, they try to create a lot of like fanciful words, a lot of difficult kind of phrases to show that they are having the good terms or words, or they are very talented, intelligent. Same here Shakespeare says that Launcelot has used these words, fates, destiny, the three sisters. Indirectly, he only want to say to old Gobo that your son is no more. He has gone to heaven. Means he died. Okay, he is amusing the audience, he is just playing with his father. He want to say that Launcelot is no more, he is dead. But he cannot say it directly, and here he is referring to fates and destiny and the three sisters. Now see, what is these three sisters? The three sisters, according to, it's a saying, the old saying, the three sisters were Clotho, Lachesis and Atropos. They were three sisters and they were called as fates and destinies. Like it's a kind of phrase, proverb it was kind. They were called as fates and destiny. So it means if something happened according to the destiny, according to the fate, So they say according to their three sisters. So these are the three sisters. So here Shakespeare is satirizing those people. Here he is giving in a satirical, satire means in a comical way. In a satirical way, he is telling those people who are not content to use plain speech but attempt to use learned words and phrases. Means they are finding difficult to use plain speech, plain words, simple words, and they show high five. In this term, you can say high five words. Learned words show off that they are very learned people. Okay, so here these three sisters, that fates and destiny, the Lancelot used to tell old Gobbo. Indirectly, you want to tell old Gobbo that Lancelot is no more, your son gone to heaven. Gobbo said, "Marry, God forbid. The boy was the very staff of my age, my very prop." Gobbo said, "Oh God, by Virgin Mary, how this happened? He was the only support of my old age, my only support, means my only staff, means my only stand with whom I can depend on this old age, Lancelot. Do I look like a cuddle or a hovel post, a staff or a prop?" Now, Lancelot did not like what his father said. He said, "Do I look like a supporter? Do I look like a short stick, which people use to support? Cuddle means the thick stick, and hovel post means a main timber supporting a poor dwelling, a poor house supported by a timber." So that he said, "Do I look like a cuddle? Do I look like a hovel post, or I look like a staff or a prop to support anyone? Do you know me, father?" Now then he said, "Don't you recognize me, father?" Gobbo, "Alack the day, I know you not," because he cannot see, and he also did not know that he is his son. So he said, "Alas, the day, I do not know you, young man. But I pray you tell me, is my boy, God rest his soul, alive or dead?" He said, "But please tell me, is my son?" And he stopped. He gave a pause. He said, "Means my son," means he wanted to know, really he died. He said, "May God give him peace." And then he paused and again said, "Dead or alive, whether he is really dead or he is alive, may God give him peace." Okay, so this way, Gobbo ended up his words, and later on again you will see how Lancelot and Gobbo, they both had a conversation, and Lancelot finally told his finally tells his father that I am your only son, and he recognized him finally, and then they go out from Shylock's house and move to Bassanio house. That we will do in the later one. Okay, I hope this much is clear to you. Write this notes in your copy. Okay, and then we will move on with the next extract, what we are